G'day, Sue. I haven't seen you recently.
Hello, Bob. No, I've been laying low working on my assignment. How about you?
I'm just on my way to collect a new Verizon Droid.
What on the world is that?
It's an Android smartphone. It's so cool, it has a gazillion top-line features including a 3.7-inch screen, 16 gigabit of memory, GPS travel instructions and loads of other stuff including a slide-out QWERTY keyboard. It's an amazing piece of handheld technology, Sue.
Why do you need a gazillion features, Bob?
Because.
And wasn't the QWERTY keyboard designed in 1874 for manual typewriters to stop commonly used keys hitting the platen at the same time? That's progress.
Sue, you're being skeptical. This is the way things are moving now. Soon we'll be able to learn on the move. You know, anywhere, anytime, anyhow. We won't have to sit down to learn. This technology is changing our lives.
For the better, Bob?
Sure, I'll be able to access my uni website, write a blog, and connect to my networks as I want. Look at you, Sue. You rely on having internet access and a computer to do this, and mostly it's in a fixed abode.
Personally, Bob, I prefer to work on a desktop with dual screens. I like the screen real estate that's not available on portable devices. It suits me to study in an undistracting environment where I can give my full undivided attention to my study. What's more, I find those tiny keys difficult to use with my long fingernails and the screens hurt my eyes after a while.
But you are so limited, Sue. Think of all the snippets of knowledge I gain from tweets, chats and texts just traveling to work. I find this so stimulating and motivating. Take me away from this technology and I feel terribly isolated.
Look at you, Bob. You're obsessed with multitasking. You continually check for messages even when there aren't any. You flit from one idea or person to another.
That's a bit hard.
I find it rude when I'm trying to have a conversation with you, when your mental bandwidth is spliced in 10 directions.
I am constantly being reinforced, Sue. This is very empowering. Look how we have meaningful discussions through Twitter back channels during conferences. As an audience, we have the power to connect and challenge the presenter. It's kinda democratic.
Well, I guess you will want a waterproof Android thingamajig, so you'll be able to tweet your fish photos while you scuba dive, Bob.
There are two theories to arguing with women, Sue, and neither one works.
But honestly, Bob, don't you think technology is moving too quickly? Research has indicated that 10% of the population are excluded from using mobile technology. This is especially so for the older generation. Some don't even know how to turn them on. This is creating a new socio-techno divide. Having gadgets like that just makes you more of a target for thieves, let alone identity snoopers tracking your every move through your GPS feature.
Well, sorry I can't convince you, Sue. But you know, Luddites eventually come around once they find themselves in the minority. Time will tell, and talking of time, I'm late, so I must fly.
Bye, Bob. Happy droiding.